those, because this is CCTV, not MTV. Is that it? Is that it?
What are we even on?
I don't know. To Roach Motel, the Halloween episode from hell. This is Roach Motel with real punk shows and real punk bands. Cause this isn't MTV, it's CCTV. So don't forget it, cause we're not for profit and we're not for profit's sake. Today I'm your host, Erica Ransom.
And I'm Evil Adam, and this is episode 14 of Roach Motel. From hell! That's we got all kinds of fucking punk rock, crazy Halloween-y stuff for you. And Erica, why don't you tell them what it's all about?
Well, as you know, we're here in the CCTV Spooky Studio. And right now, live here, in the Spitzz, dressed up as the Cramps. And they're gonna rock your socks off, right down to the bone. We're also hanging out with the punks, the ghouls, here in the studio, and we've got lots of fun things for you. We've got videos by the Misfits, we've got games, spooky tricks up our sleeves, so I'm not gonna tell you everything, but are you ready? Are you ready, Adam?
Ready!
It's the Spitzz! Live!
Yeah! The Cramps! Yeah.
Garbage man, I'll hop on it, man. nothing but a gorehound. I ain't nothing but a gorehound. All I ever do is go around, cause I ain't nothing but a gorehound like this. Ain't it nice to be nice when you can be nice? She's swell as hell, puts the cats on ice. I'm the devil with the blue dress on. I go crazy, go crazy, going, gone. Yeah, ashes to ashes and dust to dust. He's a con, he's a dog, ain't no big fuss. Cause I ain't nothing but a gore hound. I ain't nothing but a gore hound. In your blood on a Saturday night. I'm the devil with the blue dress on. I go crazy, go crazy, going down. Yeah, the devil with the blue dress on. I go crazy, going.
Hotel from Hell. Wow, we have a good guest this evening. Very spooky fellow. I have pleasure meeting him over here at CCTV. And if you're into cable access, you know this guy. You've seen his face. You've seen his work. I'm proud to have on Roach Hotel, Art Man. Come on.
Yeah, Art Man.
Hey.
Hey, Art Man. Hello. Have a roach.
Sweet.
That one
bites
the dust for you.
That's right.
Oh, so you're no stranger to this studio, Art Man.
No. It's my baby.
That's right, being the facilities coordinator, right? Studio coordinator.
That's right. I'm telling you, I'm so happy to be here. This is the 14th episode. What is it? Second place, live show. We just won an award for Roach Motel. Come on, I want to see. What?
Yeah, that's right.
I didn't know that.
It was a surprise.
Yeah! All right.
Yeah, okay.
I want to see what the other show that beat Roach Motel. I doubt it very much. Probably some sort of political thing or something.
Some crap.
Yeah.
So here we are at our award-winning cable access show. And I don't know. Tell me a little about yourself. How did you get into cable access?
I walked in. It was here. It was about 8 years ago, I walked in to become an intern. Didn't think they were going to accept me. I came in and I learned everything from there. Now I'm working here.
Wow.
What in the place?
How long you been here now?
Roach. About 8 years.
Roaches everywhere.
About 8 years, I guess.
They're coming from the garbage.
It goes.
Garbage man.
Nice. That's a delicacy in some countries.
So, you learned all your skills here, or just
from here.
Doing it, wow.
Basically, learning here. If you want to do it, you can do it here, and that's where I learned it.
Awesome.
Coming in, yeah.
Sweet. And what were the first kind of shows that you did?
First kind of shows were some whacked out shows. I know I helped my brother put out this live wrestling talk show.
Yeah.
I was just awesome. Basically played like a champion or whatever. It was all character, you know, go in as the ladies' man type of deal, champion that. I am the greatest type of deal, just like any wrestler.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm the
greatest. And then I retired from the show, trying to stay away from the show so I can do a Jesse the Body Ventura and not actually come back from retirement into the wrestling community, I guess.
Right. Do you ever think of running for governor or something?
No, but I wanted to run for city council in Cambridge. Right, yeah. Right. Alright, man. The council.
That's right. You were telling me that people on the street around Central Square, Cambridge, were kind of giving you grief about your character on the show, not being able to like separate sort of like reality from television. Yeah, or, like,
exactly. I would go on the show, like I said, I was playing conceited. It's all about me, how great I look, da 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 da. Yeah. It was just a show. The camera was off. It's just a TV show. It's wrestling.
Yeah.
I'd walk down the street and be like, hey, there's that asshole, blah 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 blah, from the wrestling show. You prick, stop throwing roaches at me and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I'm like, dude, come on, man, get a life. It's a TV show.
Like, people wanted to wrestle you and that kind of thing.
Or? Some of them did. Some of them used to sign up and say, hey, can you get me into the wrestling community? This is my application.
Oh wow.
I'm like, dude, I don't. It's just a show, man. I don't know how.
You just play one on TV.
I just play one on TV.
Awesome. All right. Well, you guys want to watch a video?
Yeah.
Got some good stuff. We're gonna watch the Misfits. If you don't know who the Misfits are, well, you're not quite punk, are you?
They're kind of mandatory on the Halloween-y episode, you know?
Yeah.
You gotta play the Fits.
Definitely. One of the first punk bands to kind of get that sort of gothic, spooky look about them, and came out early 70s, or late 70s, actually. And the video I have is from 1983. It's not the best quality video, but it's good stuff because it's in Detroit. It was one of their first shows with Robo. He's playing drums, and actually he used to be the drummer for Black Flag, so check it out. They're playing two good songs, one of them being Halloween. All right.
Yeah. The Misfits. Halloween. That's right, Roach Motel Halloween right here. We're hanging out in the studio. It's spectacular, spooktacular. And our guest again is our man, Martin. We're being pelted by roaches, by the punks over here.
By the garbage.
The garbage man, especially. And our man was just telling us about, you know, his average day of making television and how cool that is. But, and eating roaches on the side.
Of course.
You got some great costumes here. Good stuff.
Thanks. I think Garbage Man is pretty good.
Garbage Man is my favorite.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
That's where all the roaches are coming from, man. Yeah, so thanks for helping us out in a pinch, by the way.
Hey, OG.
Our guests never showed up, and Art Man, of course, is always an entertaining fellow.
OG, original gangster, the Roach Motel. That's right.
That's right.
Here from the beginning.
So, all right. Getting back down to business, I'm interested in Art Man, as are all people tuning in. And tell me, so why television? What keeps you into video and all these years? Why have you been so interested in video?
That's a good question. Is there anything else? I guess that's what keeps me here. Just love doing it.
Yeah.
Helping, showing people how to do TV, mm-hmm. I guess.
Drugs and alcohol.
Drugs and alcohol.
Right.
All that great stuff.
But television in general, not just here. I mean, why television? What draws you to television?
I don't know. I guess, I don't know, ever since I was a kid, I was into entertaining. Just going out and entertaining someone in front of a crowd or putting it on the air and stuff. And every time I watch TV, I don't know, something stupid like
that. You're a ham.
Yeah, like a political debate. And I'd say, you know what, I can make better television than that. So I would get on, you know, I'd learn
not
how to
do this. It. Come on.
Oh, but not this.
Actually, wait, you do make this.
This is why I help make
this. That's right.
Because this is great. Cool. Nothing better.
That's right.
Fuck yeah.
And since we're talking about cable access, I mean, here we are in the studio. All our friends are here. You're watching us on television. And some people don't realize like how easy this really is. I mean, it's almost spookily easy. Especially in these day and age when the media is just being conglomerated into these mega corporations. This is one venue where you can get out and have your own show at very little cost. So you just, right? Am I wrong here?
Put the word out. You want a message? I want a show. I say it all the time when I'm teaching class. If you want a show about goldfish, whatever, you can just walk in and have that show. We got a bunch of volunteers. Everybody comes in here. Look at this. This Roach Motel. You got guests. You got a party. You got the blue screen.
Hey.
Spitz.
That's right.
Right?
That's
come right. on.
Cramps.
It's good.
Right? Exactly. How can it be better than that? All you gotta do is just walk in here and do it yourself. Come in and learn how to do it.
Yeah, hey.
Who needs frickin' McDonald's to sponsor you?
Exactly.
Screw that.
Ew. All right, one more question. So what's the favorite show you've worked on besides Roach Motel?
Besides Roach Motel? Yeah.
When you look back at all the years of cable access fun you've had, is there things that stand out?
There's a couple of youth members there about, look, a snake. That's awesome. Okay. There's a couple of youth members. They're basically 18 now. They're in college and stuff. And what they do is they come in, I'm music oriented. You know, I love music.
Yeah.
So they always come in here and they got different bands. It's always a different variety. He's playing bass in this band. This guy's playing guitar in a different band. They set up the studio just like it was a stage and they got different lighting and stuff like that. Basically showing music. And they're playing music all the time. And one time they were just mocking all the people that worked at CCTV. One time they were just doing their own stuff, invited all these people from outside and had like a concert like right here in the studio.
Yeah.
And those shoots mean more to me, I guess, because it's music.
Yeah.
Hence, example, right there.
That's right.
Yeah.
Hey, is it time to listen to the Spitzz again?
I think so.
Woo! All right.
Yeah.
The Spitzz.
Rock and roll.
This one goes out to the blonde bomber. He's dead. Beating out a real one is rock and roll. Believe I.
Game here on the Roach Motel from Helm, and I call this little game Mummy Rapping.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Well, explain why we call it the Mummy Rapping game.
Basically, we got these two people here, Gretchen and James the Garbage Man, and they're going to be wrapped like mummies, basically. We've got some toilet paper, and we've got a couple of... Their comrades are gonna rap them as fast as they can to, do we have a song that's gonna go up?
Yes, we do. It's by Blondie. Possibly the worst rap you've ever heard.
The mummy rap.
That's right, so it's the mummy rap, and it is recycled toilet paper. And we did search high and low, everyone we knew to find the two most equally suited mummies of equal height to make this game totally fair. So we came up with these two people.
The tallest and the shortest person in the room.
That's right. So are our contestants ready? Do you have anything to say before we wrap you up as a mummy?
May the best man win.
You're going down!
All All right, and are the rappers ready? Woohoo!
Yeah!
All right, is Jamie's rapping team ready?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Are we ready to play Blondie? You will get for the duration of the song in order to be wrapped up. So whoever is most wrapped after the end of the song wins our grand prize of bobbleheads.
I think the term is more completely mummified.
That's right.
Mummification.
Are you prepared to enter the afterlife?
Yes.
Okay. All right, music please.
Someone say a prayer.
Blondie. Terrible rap.
Rapture. Should we get to hear it?
Oh, all yeah. Right, go!
Rapping commence!
Mythology here, the rotating around. I think she's really got some technique here. Hey, no outside help! No outside help! Oh, I see Gretchen's head is almost covered now. Torso. It looks like Trash Man is having a little more trouble. Well, let me put it this way. If, you know, we lived in a time as the ancient Egyptians did, and they believed that you needed to well preserve their bodies in order to enter the next world whole. Jamie, well, I'm sorry, you'd be on the side of the road. So. Gretchen is our winner. Yeah. And Adam, we've got our bobbleheads here. And your whole team will take home today a collector set of bobbleheads.
Right. Trophies a go-go. Bobbleheads for the winning rap.
Yes. All right, and do you have anything to say about your spectacular win today here?
Oh, it was all due to the girls. In fact, I was counterproductive by spinning the wrong way, so.
This is the coolest thing I've ever won. Woo!
It's all due to the bitch crew.